Hello. Sitting here in the studio, reading and writing poetry, doing a little meditation for somebody who just passed away. I seem a little tired, I guess, huh? Just doing a meditation. I start to get a bloody nose, so that may crop up again or continue. I'm writing death poems. So I'm in that kind of place. It's the return of non-duality, or the transubstantiation of duality, or the transcendence of duality, the reunion of duality into wuji, edgelessness. Non-duality of I and thou. Here merged. There's the wool meat. There's I and thou. In that Taijitu. There in the studio. There's the cranes from Sifu Lieberman, and the adopted fractal dragon from Kayla, and there's Janet G. There's also our Taijitu, the crane and the snake, the dragon between. I'm sitting here doing a meditation. With a knife, symbolizing the chod, the recognition of what's important, the severing of worlds, just like the umbilicus is severed too. Make two from one to enter the world. So too might the silver cord be severed when you leave the world. So I was doing a little meditation with the knife, with the Taijitu, with Janet and Kayla and Colin. Here. You may not be able to see this, but I'm among a few other swords and knives. And besides, one in my lap. So I was just going to do three breaths for three reasons. And I suppose it would be appropriate to try and balance the camera on the sword. So we'll see if that'll work. My usual, try something that was not planned at all and likely will not work. Apologize if the blood drips. So I can do three breaths for three reasons. Once from three. through and of the earth. For the earth receives, but it also lets go. Once, for, from, through humanity, for each breath has no promise of another breath. Each inhalation has no promise of a following inhalation. Each inhalation only holds the promise of an exhalation, but every exhalation offers no promise, no guarantee of an inhalation to follow. Each breath is the now. And so this breath from and of and through humanity. In the prior breath I had the spleen and stomach, and I'll hold the heart and head for this breath. The last breath, the sky, the yang quality, the quality represented by the blade, the yang, the creative blade. Necessarily can appear destructive, and yet what seems to be destruction is indeed creation. I won't go into that lesson here, but those of you that have had it in class will know what I'm referring to, the loaf of bread lesson. And so the sky, the realm of yang, of creation, creation that may seem like destruction, will have a breath of and from and through. I'm going to beat the heavenly drum. And connect to the Bahue. Yesterday's meditation about the Dakini, the sky dancer, the sky strider. Reminds me of my understanding of the crane and the snake, and my view that they didn't fight, they danced. And that is the description of the cosmos. And so that sky dancer is that Dakini suggests to me, you're dancing with the knife, dancing with the sword, dancing with what seems like destruction. Beautifully alive relationship, dancing. Dancing, as I define it, is the supporting of the unbalanced, without change, without judgment, without taking advantage of it. And so this next breath of and through and for the spirit, the sky, the heaven, the yang, the creative principle, connect to lung two and Bai Hui. The human men and the 100 meeting point. The cloud gate. 100 meeting point. Oops. There it goes. I'll do the three breaths for three reasons without any discussion. Once more. Shanti. Oh.